tools, Kuflan, that recently evolved in RIS-Kuflan. This is a joint work with Maurice, who is attending, he's in the audience, Axel from Belgium, and Alberto Lafuente from VTU Denmark. So we started working on this research line in 2015. The tool Kuflan is presented in this formal method tool paper. We have also a journal on TSC, on it, and a few months ago, we got a computers and security publication about a security-based reincarnation of the approach. Like Erode, the first tool presented, the GUI is based on Eclipse and Xtext. So we have a modern editor to write our models. And our models are written in a domain-specific language we created. This is automatically translated in a Java simulator, which is analyzed using Multivesta. Or we can export the whole discrete-time Markov chain underlying our models and ask Prism or Storm for an exact analysis. This is a pictorial representation of the interface already mentioned. So, Kuflan allows you to model so-called product lines, where the idea is that you use a macro model, a meta model, that represents a family of different models that share something in common. For example, here we represent the family of coffee machines. So, a coffee machine must sell some form of beverage. This beverage, we don't like, we decided, just to make a designing example, to be either coffee-based or tea. We don't allow coffee machines that sell both. Coffee-based can be coffee, cappuccino, or both. But since cappuccino contains coffee, if you want to sell cappuccino, you must have also coffee. And these are known as cross-tree constraints. We also imagine the ability to sell cocoa, but for some reason, if you sell cocoa, then you cannot sell tea. So this is an exclusive. So this represents any configuration of these features that respect these constraints is a legal instance, is a legal product of this family. The goal is in product lines engineering is to analyze the whole family in one go, rather than considering each single instance. So we have a domain-specific language able to express these type of constraints. Sorry. We also can define quantitative predicates over our nodes. Like in this case, we create one named price for each node. And the idea is that when you install coffee, then the machine will have price 5. If you install also cappuccino, the machine will have price 12. We also have many forms of other quantitative constraints, like we can say whatever happens, the machine cannot cost more than 10. So you will never be able to install both. And these are constraints specifying more or less the laws in my world. The dynamics is expressed using a probabilistic behavior. We use a simple probabilistic process algebra, but you can think of it as a probabilistic automaton, where depending on the node where you are, you can do a number of different actions. So you have to specify what actions you want to do, plus you can always install, replace or uninstall features, the nodes we were discussing before. So you specify the states in which your behavior can be, and the transitions are, you give them like this, like from factory, I can do this action with this weight, or this one with this weight, or this one with this weight. At each time point, each transition is performed with probability given by the ratio of its weight over all the weights of the admitted transitions. Because if you try to install Cappuccino, but you already have it, this transition will be ignored in some sense. We also admit for variables that we can modify when executing our dynamics. This facilitates the analysis, for example. And I will give you examples of analysis we can do for risk Kuflan rather than for Kuflan. So what happened at a certain point is that we noticed that product lines look very much like attack trees or fault trees mentioned this morning in one of the talks. The idea is that here these constraints don't represent families of products, but conditions necessary to perform an attack. So this is a simple attack defense tree where an attacker wants to rob a bank, then you should either open the vault or blow it up. And to open the vault, you need both to learn the combination and get the vault. Or here we were imagining that you need to know 2 out of 3 codes, but there is a defense node that prevents or makes this attack node more difficult. And we have also countermeasure defense nodes, which are like proactive defense nodes that get activated only in certain conditions. So in order to model this type of constraints, we could not use directly Kuflan for several reasons. We need different type of nodes, attack, defense, and countermeasures. We need more constructs like AND, order at AND, AND out of K, activates, inhibits. Also, in Kuflan, whenever you were trying to install a feature, you were always succeeding. Instead, attacks might fail, and many other changes we have to do to get to be able to model this type of methods. So a little bit like in Kuflan, in RISC-Kuflan, we express the constraints that a probabilistic attacker must satisfy to get to its goal, or and a probabilistic behavior given in terms of some simple process algebra. We think of it as a probabilistic automaton again. And the type of analysis we can do using Multivesta is, for example, estimating the probability of succeeding in each of the attacks, in each of the attack nodes in all steps from 1 to 100. And this is the result we get. We are extending this analysis also to consider steady state case. The interesting thing here is that by considering different attackers, you can study how your defenses work for different attackers, like the teenager that attacks you online or some powerful organization. You can encode this type of different attackers here. And as I said, we can also export for the input formalism supported by both Prism and Storm, which are very popular exact probabilistic model checkers. And if the state space of the model is finite, you can export it and ask these tools to perform exact analysis. In this case, the state space is infinite, but here you find more case studies, including the computers and security paper containing the case studies studied there. Okay. And I'm done.
Well, perfect, because